Hi, I'm David. I want to share with you something that to me is represents a lot of the power of the simplicity of the GTD process once you get it. I'm often asked, and we often run into this, where people say, well, gee, David, all this stuff is really great about getting focused, getting organized and everything, but boy, the interruptions just come at me. How on earth can I deal with all of that when I get all that unexpected input? And I want to show you just as best I can here to try to demonstrate how powerful this simple little three-sided thing called an in-basket can be just for managing that kind of thing. One of the best examples is, think about, have you ever come in early? You know, if you think about the times you've come in early, you sort of got on your game, you're in control, you're in the driver's seat, and you're working on something, right? You ever been there? So I'm here early and I'm working, and then the phone rings, you know, some different time zone or whatever. And, you know, the phone rings. I go, okay, so now I answer the phone, right? So now I'm picking up the phone and I'm talking on the phone, and they're talking about XYZ, and I'm trying to, you know, write the, then somebody else comes in early. So now as the phone's hanging up, this person walks in, hands me this project, and they say, David, what am I doing? And then you came in early, and in 2.6 minutes, you're out of control. Now, if you can relate to that at all, let me just show you a simple little trick. You may be doing it intuitively anyhow, but that's why the in-basket can be such a powerful tool. Watch this. Let's say that happens to me. Let's say I'm in early and I'm working on something. So now I'm working on whatever I'm working on. The phone rings. If I decide to pick up that phone, I will turn over, I will pick up the phone, and then I take what I was working on, drop it back into the in-basket. Then I take my notepad while I'm on the phone. Now I'm taking notes based upon this new input that's happening to me. I get off the phone. As I'm getting off the phone, somebody else shows up with something. I take this. By the way, it's a real good idea to be in the habit of dating that, just so I know. Sometimes I'll even put the time on it. So I'll put the date, and I'll put the time, and tear this note off, drop it in there. That way, if a person comes in here, they say, David, and I go, oh, yes, thank you very much. That's fabulous. I make a little note on that. I stick that on here. And they walk out, and in 2.6 minutes, I'm still in control. Why? Because I've got now placeholders for each one of those things that was going on right here. Now, this only works if I can trust that before the end of the day, I'm going to drive back through these things and pick them up. So I have to trust that I'm also processing these things, but now I can pick this up. I can make now the decision about what this is in my own timing without them standing there. Whether I want to work on it or not, I may just need to organize that. But I also have the note from the phone call to remind me here. I also have the work in progress that I was working on that I threw back in there because it was in progress and I still probably needed to figure out what the next step is. So if you get the idea, this little three-sided thing really is a very powerful tool. But again, this will only work if some part of me knows it's going to look like that sooner than later. Maybe not every day, but at least if I know I'm going to get that empty within 24 to 48 hours, then there's a part of me that can trust just throwing things in there is a sufficient trigger. Then I can go do whatever I do, but I need a corral, not all over this desk in one place, to be able to toss the stuff back in there. Again, with the discrete use of the in-basket, very powerful tool to be able to allow you, even very sophisticated environments, as the stuff is coming at you that way, to be able to keep placeholders in place. Hope that's helpful.